Hi all, I'm very excited to announce that I have developed a website for Abacus to practice online. So the website name is practiceabacusonline.com. So as the name says, you can practice Abacus online. Pause the video right now and open the website practiceabacusonline.com and come back here. There are many things that we need to discuss. So before me explaining, so I want you to explore the website and come back here. Bookmark the website or just remember the website name because you will be using it daily. I know that you will be practicing daily on our website. It will be very helpful to you to improve your speed and Abacus skills. And one more thing, I hope you have visited the website. And if you did not understand anything on the website, don't worry. I'll explain all of them in this video. So keep watching until the end. I'll explain in detail everything about the website. Now let's start with the actual video. Why did I create this website? When I was teaching, still I'm teaching, I found that students are confined only to the assignments. So for example, if any student want to practice more beyond the assignments, he or she could not do it. And because there were very less resources which were available online, I tried to find flashcards, dictations, decimal multiplications, everything for Abacus which is there on internet, but I could not find the correct website where student could practice all of them in one single place. So I found one or two websites which had only flashcards or dictations, but you will not have many options like decimals or multiplications or anything. You'll only have one or two options which are not much useful. So I wanted to create one website where students can practice all of them in one single place. Yeah, one more important thing why I created this website is students who want to practice more can use this website. Or else if you don't have books or any practice materials, still you can use this website to improve your speed, and just for practicing Abacus, you can use this website. I wanted to create a website where you can have different kinds of practice materials all at one single place, and I have done that just for you. So I hope you will open the website and you'll practice the website daily. Now let's get started with different practice materials that I have developed, like flashcards, dictations, speed round, infinite mode set. There are many things. We will see them one by one now. So I'll be creating separate videos and a separate playlist for each of the practice material. I'll be releasing them one by one from today. In the meantime, you can open the how to use page. You can see one page called as how to use page. That is just like a manual. You can read all the questions. I suggest you to read all the questions so that you'll get an idea how to use it, and also you'll get one brief understanding of what each practice material is. But in this video, I will give you a very high level understanding of each practice material. So first let's get started with flashcards. So what are flashcards? Flashcards are nothing but it's not like you practice the questions in the notebook or any practice book. So flashcards, what happens is you will have the numbers. You need to select, or you need to open the settings and select the number of digits and number of rows you want to practice. For example, if we have a question like 17 plus 29 minus 36. Okay, if you have this question in books, the entire question will be printed. But in flashcards, what happens is you can't see all the questions at a time. Each number will be flashed at a time. So first 17 will be flashed, next only 29 will be flashed, next minus 36 will be flashed. So in this way, you can see the numbers, you can solve the questions. And what is the difference in flashing the two numbers is, it's called as speed. So it is called as flash speed. You can set the that speed in the settings. So all these details I'll be screen sharing and showing it to you in a separate video, and I'll create a playlist for that. So this is called as flashcards. So why flashcards are very helpful is, so if you practice on paper, all the questions will be printed. So this is first question, second question, like this 10 questions will be printed. In this way, this is the traditional way to practice Abacus. You will have a printout and you'll have all the questions. But if you practice flashcards, you'll improve your speed. Why? Because here on paper, you can see all the questions at a time. You can see all the numbers at a time. And also, you'll not be forced to solve quickly. If you want to solve this question, you can solve it in 1 second or 10 seconds, or even you can take 1 hour to solve this question. But in flashcards, you can't do it like that. So for example, if you do this in flashcards, first 17 will be flashed, next 29 will be flashed, next minus 36 will be flashed. So there is some dedicated time to this. After that time, you can't see the question, you can't solve the question. So in that way, you will be forced to solve quickly. So what happens is, if you set the time limit as 1 second gap between two numbers. So here 17 will be flashed, there will be 1 second gap, 29, 1 second gap, minus 36. So this entire question you will be solving in 3 seconds only. So in this way, you can vary the speed according to your speed and you can try to improve your speed. So there is a time limit here. So in that way, you can improve your speed. So that's why flashcards are very important. So even coming to my personal experience, I practice flashcards only and they only help me to improve my speed. So I practice flashcards too much, and dictations also. So what are dictations? I'll tell you. Just now I told you what are flashcards. In flashcards, the number will be flashed on the screen. But dictations are almost same, but you will not be seeing the numbers. You'll only hear the numbers. So what is that? First, you'll open the website. You'll select all the settings and you'll click on let's go. Now what happens is,
start 51, minus 33, 71, minus 23, 96, answer.
You can't see any question. You can't see any question, but you'll hear the numbers from the computer. So first 17 will be spoken, next 29, next minus 36. In this way also you can practice. So flashcards and dictations are almost similar, but except that in dictations it will be dictated, in flashcards the numbers will be flashed. In our website you can see many options in dictations. You can select any voice you want. So these two are most important in the website and they really help in improving your speed. So what are the benefits of flashcards and dictations? So first thing is your speed will improve and you can practice any number of questions you want. You can apply various settings to this. So all these settings I'll be showing in that video. I'll be adding to the playlist. And second thing is you can improve your concentration. So if you keep on practicing flashcards, your concentration will improve. And if you practice dictations, you will hear the question. So your listening skills will improve. Also, your focus will also improve if you practice dictations. One more important thing is, in our website, there is an option called as dictations. So if you want to select that option, the computer only will speak the question. But if someone want to dictate the question, just open the flashcards and ask your parents or friends or your siblings to read the question. In that way also you can practice dictations. So that is the second option on how to practice dictations. Now let's see what is the second practice material, which is called a speed round. So what is speed round is, for example, if you are preparing for a competition or any exam or any assessment, there is certain time limit. I'll erase the board. So there is certain time limit. In that time limit only you need to solve the questions. Beyond the time limit, you will not be allowed to solve the questions. So what happens in that time? You will be given a paper and you will be given some time, 5 minutes or 3 minutes or any time, 10 minutes. You will be given time limit. So you will be given, for example, 100 questions. 100 questions. So what happens here is, this you are doing on paper. You are setting a time limit and you are doing on paper. But the same thing if you want to do on the website. So how is that possible? What you should do is, so that's why I developed speed round. What is speed round? It is exact same thing as this one. You will be having infinite questions. So if you solve Here there are only 100 questions, but in the website there will be infinite questions. You can solve as many questions as possible in certain time limit. So you can set a time limit. For example, if you set the time limit as 5 minutes, the time will start when you click on start, and you can solve as many questions as you like. And after the time is done, you will not be able to enter the answers. So in that way, this will be helpful. Speedrun will be helpful to practice for assessments or competitions or any exams. So all this walkthrough video I'll be making and adding to a playlist. So what is the benefit of this speedrun? It will be helpful for you to practice for competitions and assessments or any exams. You can use our website and practice. So what is the right way to practice speedrun? See, in competitions, what happens is, for example, if you are doing 30 questions for the first time, you are doing 30 questions, what you should try to aim for the next time, you should do greater than or equal to 30 questions for the second time. What does this mean? You should not do less than 30 questions. For example, if you are doing 30 questions for the first time, you should do 30 or more than that number of questions for the second time. It's okay if you are able to do 25 also. That's not every time you can't do 30. 25 greater than or equal to 25. You should be able to do 25 questions or more than that for second time. In this way, you should test and challenge yourself. You should not do less than 25 questions. If you are doing less than 20 questions, then you're decreasing your speed. If you are doing more than 30 questions or you are maintaining the same speed, then you will improve your speed. So that is the right way to practice speedrun. And even in competitions also, you should challenge yourself to improve the speed. So you should do more number of questions each and every time. You should not decrease your speed. Now there is one more thing, one more practice material that I have developed, which is called as set. So set is nothing but it is almost same as your practice material which you have in your books or assignments. So generally, how do you have your assignments in books? You will be having 10 questions in a table. You will be having all the numbers like this. So you'll be having all the numbers. You'll have one box here, time taken. You'll be having all the questions here, second question, third question. You will be having one more box here to write the answers. So this is on paper. So what if you want to do the exact same thing on the website? So you should open a practice material called as set. In that set, what happens is, you can set the number of questions you want to practice. You can't set the time. You can set the number of questions you want to practice. For example, if you want to practice only 10 questions, just set the number of questions for 10 as 10, and you can take how much ever time you want. For example, if you are taking 30 seconds for 10 questions, it's okay. Even if you take 1 hour for those 10 questions, that's also okay. It's not like speed round where time is limited. Here you can take how much ever time you want, but questions are limited. So if you are done with 10 questions, then the website will tell you how much time you have taken. If you want to do 11th question, it will not be possible. How this set will help in improving your speed? The same technique as in speed round. If you are doing 10 questions 30 seconds for the first time, you should try to do the same 10 questions, not same 10 questions, the same syllabus, the same problems, similar problems and similar concept. You should try to do at least 35 seconds or less than that. You should not take 1 minute, or you should not take 2 minutes second time. If you are taking this much time for the second time, then you are not improving your speed. You are decreasing your speed. If you want to improve your speed, do the same 10 questions 2 times or 3 times and try to decrease the speed. So second time you should do, for example, 28 seconds, third time 27 seconds. In this way, if you are doing, then you are improving your speed. So this way, in the website, you can improve your speed. This is called as set. Now coming to infinite mode. So there is one more practice material called as infinite mode. What is this infinite mode is? It is almost same as flashcards, but it is infinite. You will have infinite questions, and there is one more advantage here. If you don't want to enter the answer like in flashcards, you can practice infinite mode. So what happens here is, you will the numbers will be flashed just like in flashcard, but also the answer will be displayed. For example, if the question is 1 plus 2 plus 3, along with the question, answer also will be displayed after some time. So is equal to 6 means the answer is 6 for this. So in this way, the questions will be keep on coming. Infinite questions will be there. So it will not stop until you stop. There is one stop button. If you click on the stop button, then only it will stop. So why this is helpful is, if you are traveling or if you don't want to enter answers, if you are lazy to enter the answers, you can open the infinite mode. You can set the configuration and start playing. You need not enter the answer. You can calculate in your mind and just check. So if on computer only, you will see the answer also. So you, it is like self-assessment. If you got the answer as 5 and the answer is 6, then it is wrong. So only you know whether the answer is correct or not. So in this way, you can use the infinite mode. Yeah, now all this practice materials we have seen, like flashcards, dictations, speed round, set and infinite mode. I'll be making a separate video, a detailed video about all this practice materials, so that you'll get a complete idea. In this video, since the video is getting longer, I don't want to discuss all of them in single video. I'll be making a separate playlist so that you will have a clear idea. There is one more important thing I forgot to mention. You can also see the results. That is the beauty of this website. So just like you have, you correct the answers manually on paper. For example, if you are practicing on a book, you'll have some questions, and after you write the answers, you need to check the answers. But here on the website, when you enter the answers, the computer will automatically generate the results. So there is one button called as results. When you click on that, you will see all the details. What is the selected speed? Did you include subtractions? What were the number of rows? How much time did you take for each question? What is the time? Everything you will see. And one more good thing about these results is, you can also see what mistakes you have made and also what was the correct answer. For example, if you got the answer as 134, but the correct answer is 135, you can see both of them. Along with that, you can see question number and question. In this way, you can retrospect yourself. So where did I make mistake? So this is called as a one bead error. So only there is one bead error here. So this is a famous mistake which many of the students make. You can also see mistakes made along with that correct answers. So there are many things in results. Now coming to the important question, who can use the website? If you know all the addition and subtraction concepts like small friends, big friends and lazy friends, then it is very helpful for you and you can start using the website. But if you only know simple addition, small friends, and you don't know the rest of the addition and subtraction concepts, you first learn all the concepts, like all the addition and subtraction concepts, then you can start using the website. Why? Because if you right away start using the website, it will be a little difficult for you. I have designed this website for laptops, desktops, and also tablets, but mobiles are not recommended. But if you don't have any laptop or any other device other than mobile, you can use it. There is no problem. But if you have a laptop or any tablet, I suggest you to use the website only on laptop or desktop or any tablet. But if you don't have them, it's okay. You can use it on mobile. And one more important thing is, you should open this website on Google Chrome only. Why? Because all the features will work in Google Chrome only. If you open in any other browser like Mozilla or Microsoft Edge or Safari, some features might not work. So use only Google Chrome. And one more thing, if you are using tablets or any mobiles, keep it in portrait every time you practice. So keep it like this, not like this. This is landscape, don't keep it like this. This is called as portrait. Keep it like this to show you clearly. So if you want to practice, keep it like this, don't keep it like this. Now coming to one more thing, how parents can use this website for their kids for abacus practices. You can open any of the practice material like flashcards, speed round or set. And if you want to practice daily for 10 minutes, what you should do is open any practice material. You can set the number of questions. You can set the number of questions or you can set the time. If you want to practice for 10 minutes daily, open speed round. There is time limit. As I said just now, there is time limit in speed round. Set the time for 10 minutes. Practice for 10 minutes and you can see the results. So what you should do with that result, you should take a screenshot of the result whenever you are practicing. So why is that? Because you can track your speed. For example, if you are doing, let's say, 10 questions in 30 seconds now. But after 6 months or 1 year, if you take screenshots regularly and keep it, store it somewhere in a separate folder on your computer or mobile, it will be easy for you to track the speed. In this month is December, right? In December, you are doing 10 questions in 30 seconds. But after 6 months, in June, if you practice regularly, so 10 questions, you might do in 10 seconds only. So you should take the result screenshot to compare your own speed. You should check your own speed, how you are doing in each month, in each week, so that it will be easy for you to see where you are making mistakes and what is your problem. Now that we have released the website, I hope you will love the website and you will practice daily on the website. In case if you want to give any feedback, you can give the feedback on the WhatsApp number below, or else you can just comment on this video whether you have liked the video, whether you have liked the website, or you are using the website daily. Or one more thing is, if you are facing any issues while using the website, just inform me. You can WhatsApp or you can comment on this video. I will try to fix the issue. So I hope you will love the website, and I hope all of you visit the website and start practicing to improve your speed. So once again, as I said you that in this video, this is just an introduction video and I did not dig deep into all the practice materials. I'll be making a separate video on all the practice materials. You will have a detailed information about all the practice materials in those videos. I'll be releasing them one by one from today. So you can watch that videos, and still if you have any issues, you can comment below or else you can WhatsApp.
We have put a lot of effort in developing this website. We try to use our experience from our Abacus practice and try to develop features so that you and your kids can excel in Abacus practice. So we are really looking forward for you and your kids to use the Abacus website and get better at Abacus. So keep practicing, and sure, do let us know if you would like to see any new features in the website, and share any feedback that you have. Keep doing good. Keep practicing. Thank you very much.